Ah, I won.
That must be because you have an owl.
Of course, every wizard needs an owl.
You know that in Shanxi Museum, we have different kinds of magic birds.
Really?
Yeah, why don't you go and check them out?
These red spots and patches of green rust tell the story of an ancient civilization.
Chinese bronze is so captivating because seeing the pieces in a museum, one can only imagine what they have seen, how they were used, and by who.
But I'm more concerned about where the owl is.
A closer look reveals that its feet are pointing inwards, giving it an innocent, almost cute appearance.
它是中国古代祭祀时非常重要的一件酒礼器，里面盛放的是一个叫做巨秤的酒水，主要就是专门祭祀神灵的。
In fact, this pendant almost resembles an ancient version of the game Angry Birds. In ancient Greek mythology, owls were believed to be an incarnation of the goddess of wisdom, whilst in folklore, they are often believed to be messengers. For people in ancient civilizations, the natural world would have been an extremely confusing place.
They would attribute many natural phenomena to the supernatural.
This is something that Eastern and Western cultures have in common. It was believed that because birds fly so high, they were closer to the supernatural, to the sun, to God, and that this is what gave them their wisdom.
Hello, Rees, it's me.
What?
Yeah.
Who are you? Where from? What do you do?
I'm Niaozi. I come from China 3,000 years ago. I am a wine vessel. 凤首相尾，尊贵如我。你看我的样子，这鸟冠，这尖喙，还有这通体漂亮的羽毛，在中国人的心目中，我是一只代表着祥瑞的鸟，凤鸟。我的主人是当时这里的国君。 尽管我只是只成酒器，但从开始到现在，所有人都把我当宝贝。抓住小鸟捉手，打开盖，酒可以从这里注入或取出。每逢祭祖，我都会和君王一起呀，登上殿堂，奉上香甜的礼酒。礼酒，对，你可以理解成是一种原始啤酒，是用发芽的谷物酿制。Oh.
I like beer too.
我被发现的时候，完全是散落在泥土里的一堆碎片。我生怕他们认不出我，但没想到文物专家和技术人员坚持不懈地完成了对我的发掘和修复。你别说，就这个执着昂扬的劲头和他们的祖先一模一样。他们用了二十年还我真容，那我必然要用三千年积淀，奉还一段礼仪中国的故事。 All right, enough said. Please attend a grand banquet of the spring and autumn period with me.
In China, items of bronzeware are classified as heavy artifacts, not just because of their size, but because of the spiritual weight they carry.
Long ago, enormous cauldrons would have been used for feasting and for making offerings to the gods. As a part of this ritual, people would have also struck bells and played music, believing that this would entertain the gods. Born out of these Bronze Age traditions was a culture that was built on ritual and etiquette.